Good morning, NBTHS. I'm Anthony.
I'm Javian, and this is NBT News.
Our first story comes to us from the Principal's Advisory Board in place of the Principal's Corner.
Yes, the Advisory Board has been working very hard on this video, so let's check it out.
Before driving, always have a legal permit with you or a license. Also, of course, stay strapped, wear your seatbelt, and don't text and drive.
Also, don't FaceTime while you're driving. Make sure that you're not driving under the influence, and make sure that you're of a legal age to be driving.
Are you a responsible driver, Dan?
Yes. Are you?
I am.
Good job.
Also, when you guys are driving, make sure to stay off your phones, keep your music at an appropriate level, and all passengers in your car need to obey your car rules. Remember, it's your car.
My day was trash. I hated everything.
Wait, did you hear that?
Oh my god!
What?
Where?
What?
Where?
Where?
To remember that you need to
drive the speed limit.
Stop when pedestrians are coming.
Signal when turning.
Stop at that stop sign.
Now shut up and drive. Shut up and drive. Shut up and drive.
Very cool. Great message. Pay attention while driving.
Agreed. We have a special message from two DECA students about Business Academy. Let's check that out.
Are you interested in business? Do you want to learn more about marketing? How about finance?
Perhaps even multimedia.
Maybe you want first choice to business classes by beloved teachers such as these. Well, join the North Brunswick Township High School Business Academy. Let's get an interview from this lad who's the Vice President of the Business Academy. Trust me, he's had so much fun.
I'm here with Nish Parikh. He's a 3-year member of the Business Academy and he's also the Vice President. Nish, how's your experience been so far in the Business Academy?
Oh, it was pretty good. I started out as a sophomore, introduced to the program. And through the 3 years, I've got introduced to Rutgers Business for You, which is a program linked with Business Academy, which basically lets you get two mentors, and you can gain knowledge about Rutgers Business School as a whole before you even attend it. And then also through the Business Academy, if you're in it, you can get first dibs on business courses offered at NBT. Thank you.
For more information, contact Mr. Speller at aspeller@mbtschools.org or Mr. Kopic at rkopic@mbtschools.org. Go Raiders!
Next up, we have Ryan with a story about Christmas traditions. Do you have any traditions?
Actually, I do, Javian. My family likes to celebrate Christmas a day early because that's how it's celebrated in Hungary. So, that's something we do. Does your family have any traditions?
We do. We actually stay up until around 12, open gifts, and then don't go to sleep until like 6.
Awesome! Let's hear what our other students have to say about it. Ryan?
Thanks, guys. Today we are going to be asking people about their family Christmas traditions.
Hi, I'm here with
Alana.
And what do you do for a Christmas tradition?
I go with my grandparents to eat breakfast and dinner for Christmas.
Yeah. Hi, I'm here with
Joy.
And what do you do for a Christmas tradition?
On Christmas Eve, we stay up and party, and then at 12, we unwrap the presents.
Hi, I'm here with
Danielle.
And what do you do as a family tradition for Christmas?
On Christmas Eve, we each open one gift, and then on Christmas Day, we have a Christmas dinner.
Hi, what's your name?
Mahali.
And what do you do as a Christmas tradition?
I usually open gifts at 12 on the 24th instead of the 25th. So we do nothing on like Christmas Day, actually. So, yeah.
Cool. Hi, I'm here with
Nigeria Jones.
And what do you do as a holiday tradition?
Me and my family, we celebrate Kwanzaa. Kwanzaa starts December 26th, ends to January 1st. We light the candle, we sing, dance, read poetry, tell stories.
Awesome. Hi, I'm here with
Linda.
And what do you do as a Christmas tradition?
Open presents and then eat a lot of food.
That's all the interviews for today. Have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Some of those traditions I've heard of, but we're actually going to break a tradition now.
What do you mean?
Well, usually it's Nico eating someone else's food and reviewing it. But this time it's Nico baking a cake and some lucky people got to try it.
Oh, come on. Hey, I like cake. Why wasn't I included?
I wasn't either, but let's see what people had to say about his cake.
Thanks, guys. And welcome to the Christmas baking special for the NBT News. Today, we'll be making a red velvet cake with the Christmas love that we all want this year. I have all the ingredients and what we're going to be using: oil, water, eggs, instant pudding, red velvet cake, of course, and butter. And we have everything to decorate it with. So now, let's get started.
Thank you for watching me bake a cake, and thank you to all the people that tried the cake. Thanks for your reviews. I hope everyone has a happy holiday, and now let's get back to the studio.
It looked pretty good. Very moist.
Don't say that word.
What word? Moist?
Let's move on.
Does that word make you uncomfortable?
Our next story is from Jessica. She asked around about favorite Netflix shows.
I wonder if there's a show called Moist.
Thanks, guys. I'm Jessica Garzon. Today, I'm going to be interviewing students and asking them what their favorite Netflix show is. Let's see what they say. I'm here today with
AJ.
AJ, what's your favorite Netflix show right now?
On My Block.
How come?
I really like shows that can keep my interest the whole show through. And with On My Block, there's never a dull moment. It goes from gang violence to money heist to relationship issues and even school issues like what we experience in school.
Wow, that's amazing. I'm here today with
Jason.
Jason, what's your favorite Netflix show right now?
My favorite Netflix show is Money Heist. It's a Spanish show about heists on the Bank of Spain and other places.
Ooh, who's your favorite character from Money Heist?
My favorite character is probably this girl named Tokyo. She's a very powerful character.
Tell me more about her. What does Tokyo do?
She's probably the leader of the group of robbers, and she's a very hot attitude, but she's a good leader at the end of the day and is always there for all of them.
Okay, thank you so much, Jason. Wizzy, what's your favorite Netflix show right now?
Stranger Things.
How come?
It's interesting and it has a lot of supernatural like things.
Who's your favorite character from that show?
Max.
How come?
Our personalities are alike and we're just like the same person almost.
I love that. Rose, what's your favorite Netflix show right now?
My favorite Netflix show is Vampire Diaries.
What's Vampire Diaries about?
It's like a love triangle between a girl and two brothers, and there's like supernatural things that go on.
Okay, Rose, what's your favorite character from that show?
Stefan.
How come?
I think he's really hot, and I like his personality.
All right, thank you so much, Rose. Wow, these students had a bunch of amazing answers. I think I'm going to watch some of these shows when I get home. Back to you at the studio.
I've heard of most of them, but there are a couple I haven't seen.
No, there's no show called Moist.
Let It Go.
Oh, like the song.
Yes, just like that. And a nice segue by you.
Oh, you mean because we have Linda talking about new music as our next story.
Yes.
I wonder if there's a song called Moist.
Linda, please end this, please.
Hi, I'm Linda Turret, and today we're going to talk about the music reviews between Drake and Kanye's new album. Did you listen to Drake's new album?
Yeah.
What do you think about it?
It was good.
Okay. Do you have a favorite song on the album?
Girls on Girls.
What do you think about Drake's album?
I mean, it's all right. It has a good few songs on it, but I mean, you know.
Do you have a favorite on Drake's album?
Way Too Sexy, Future, and Young Thug Go Hard on that song.
Yeah. I'm too sexy for this sir. Too sexy for your girl. Too sexy for this world. Too sexy.
What do you think about it?
It's really good.
Do you have a favorite song?
No.
Why not?
They're all pretty good.
Did you listen to Drake's album?
Yeah.
What do you think about it?
It's alright.
Do you have a favorite song?
I'm gonna say Into Deep. Yeah, Into Deep.
Did you listen to Kanye's new album?
Yeah.
What do you think about it?
It was good.
Do you have a favorite song?
Hurricane.
Okay. Did you listen to Kanye's album?
A little bit.
Did you like it?
I mean, I'm not really one to listen to Kanye, but I mean, it wasn't really my taste. So, I mean, it's up in the air.
Do you have a favorite on the album or no?
Nah, I got no favorite on the album.
How come?
Like I said, Kanye ain't really my musical taste, so I mean, I wasn't really feeling the songs on his album.
Did you listen to Kanye's new album?
Yeah.
What do you think about it?
It's the best thing I've heard.
Do you have a favorite?
Yeah. It's Off the Grid. We off the grid, grid, grid. This for my kid, kid, kid. When my kids have kids,
everything we did for the crib, everything we did, how we lived, all this smoke got us. Did you listen to Kanye's album?
Definitely.
What do you think about that one?
Way better.
Better than Drake's?
10 out of 10, without a doubt.
How come?
Because the production, everything, the features, it's great.
Do you have a favorite song on Kanye's?
Off the Grid.
Right. That's the music reviews for this month. Now back to the studio.
Look, there are tons of songs with Moist in the title, and there's even a band.
Enough! Oh, let's get to our final story. Jaquil is speaking to students about looking back on 2021, and then forward to 2022.
What are you looking forward to in 2022?
I look forward to graduating and going to Emory on a full ride.
Nice! Okay, well, let's see what students have to say. Jaquil?
Thank y'all. And today, we've decided to ask students how they felt about this year and the year prior and their future. What do you wish you did different this year?
Honestly, I wish I didn't try to be bold and put myself out there, because that just, it doesn't always like end up, it doesn't really have the outcome that you expect, but you live and you learn. Next time, I'll just attract everything and let things come to me.
And what are you looking forward to in the year 2022?
Well, next year I'm looking for new vibes, new people, better opportunities for my dream goals, you know, just bigger and better things.
And how do you feel about the year 2021?
I kind of liked how we're getting back to normal. I got to be out more with my friends and got to do like the regular activities I do.
Agreeable. And what do you find was the most eventful time of the year for you?
Coming back to school, and I'm a senior, so I'm graduating soon. Yeah.
How's your school year going so far, Melvin?
It's going pretty great. I had to go to different events. Right now I do photography for the team, so I get to be out all the time, and I get to work on edits and pretty much do whatever I want.
And what is the most memorable thing you've had this year?
Going to Puerto Rico this summer was fun. I got to see my family members I hadn't seen in a while.
And that's how our students feel. Now back to the studio.
You asked me, now let me ask you. What are you looking forward to?
I'm looking to finally get some sleep in 2022.
I agree. That'll just about wrap it up for this edition of NBT News.
But before we go, let's take a look at some upcoming events. This week, the SGO Hershey Kisses stocking fundraiser is going on. Monday, December 20th, kicks off the Class of 2022 Pi fundraiser. Interims are right around the corner. Wednesday, December 22nd is the final Wellness Wednesday of 2021. Thursday, December 23rd is a 12-12 closing, but at lunch, come to the Commons and check out the band at Christmas in the Commons. School is closed from Friday the 24th and reopens on Monday, January 3rd. The 25th is Christmas and the 26th is Kwanzaa, and of course, the 31st is New Year's Eve. Girls basketball is hosting a basketball tournament this week between Christmas, and boys basketball is playing in one in South Brunswick. Both boys and girls track are running in two events in Toms River during the week. Get out and support all the Raiders sports teams.
That will bring this month's news to a close.
From everyone here at NBT News, we wish you a happy holiday season.
Be safe over the holidays.
Bye for the year.